स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सुमेय इंग्लिश प्राइमरी स्कूल क्लास सिक्स एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज इंग्लिश ग्रामर एंड द चैप्टर इज 7, 8 and 9 एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज नाउन्स दैट इज अ पॉजिटिव केस एंड द 8th चैप्टर इज एजेंट नाउन्स एंड द 3rd वन इज द प्रोनाउन्स एंड डिटरमाइनर्स. द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज पॉजिटिव नाउन्स which can be in the possessive case also we can say it down. The noun shows the possession. It means when the noun is in the possessive case, it always denotes the ownership, kind, authorship. That is known as the possessive case. Here is an example we can say it down. It is Shamim's lunchbox. That means here we are describing about the lunchbox. Whose lunchbox is it? Is Shamim's. That means the lunchbox ownership is the Shamim's. That's why it is said as a possessive case, which is also known as a possessive noun. She likes to read Shakespeare's plays. There is no alternative of the mother's love. And the Prime Minister's speech inspired everyone. So in everything, in every sentences, there is some ownership or the authorship which can be in the possessive case. So here was the example. Now the next we will see about the agent noun. So this noun do a specific action and many verbs can be also changed into the agent nouns. And we create a noun by using a verb here. Whenever we want to create the agent noun, whenever we use the agent noun, there will be a verb also. It is the name given to a person. It is a simple sentences here. That means whatever it is there, we are giving the name to a person which is connected with a certain job or the certain work the person is doing or any activity or any function is there. Means any word we are particularly, we are identifying that things. Here is an example we can say it down in the agent nouns. That is someone that dances is called a dancer. That means the dancer is an agent noun. That means it is a certain job or any work he is doing. That is we have given the name. The person who is dancing, that is means he is a dancer. This dancer word is the agent nouns. So we are creating here noun by using the verb. So this was the agent nouns. The next here we can see the example here. Agent nouns example, actor, dancer, driver means the person who is driving anything. We have given the name driver. Painter, the person who paints. Player, runner, singer, skier, teacher, translator, worker means they are doing some certain job or doing any work. That means we have given the word, whatever the work they are doing, that is known as the agent nouns. So next our topic is the pronoun. Now we will see here what is pronoun. It is a word which is used in the place of a noun. Words like they, she, he and it are the words which are used in the place of noun, which is known as the pronoun. You can see the example here. So many words are there which we are using this words in the place of the noun. That means I, me, she, we, they, who, that, yours, his, her, it, etc. These are the words which we replaces the nouns. Means she or her. See, here is the example is given with the picturization, them or they, that is the it. So these are the example of the pronouns. Here also you can see the example here, personal pronouns. In the pronouns, that is a personal pronouns, that means the two things is there, first person, second person and third person. In all this person we will first see about the singular. That means the first person means we, I. And the object we are talking, me. That is only one person is there here. Second person singular means you. We are talking about the yours. Third person singular will be he, she or it. All the things are in the singular form only. Only one person we are talking, but here we are talking about the three persons. That means first person, second person, and third person. If we will talk about in the plural form, the same personal pronouns, that means we, that goes in the subject forms, that means the in the plural form it is there. That when goes in the object means us, we and the us. Second person in the plural form, we will go there as a you. In the object also as it is, it will be in the you form only. And in the third person plural, it goes as a they. It is a subject, and in the object if we will talk about, they goes into the them. So here was the example. Now the next topic is our determiners. It is a words which introduce a noun and also provide the information about the sentences. That means it gives us some information about the sentences, but it does not describe it. Here is a two meaning it is given. There should be no confusion in the sentence. Determiners is the word which introduces. It gives us a noun and it provides us some information, but it does not describe anything about it. It doesn't describe, it only give the information. For example, you can see the ball. Means the ball is there. It is not describing about the ball. It is just giving the information about the noun. His son, five cats, more cars. So these are the determiners. Now here we will see the next topic, that is the reflexive pronouns. Reflexive means just it reflects to the subject in the sentence. Reflection, always we use a common word, it is reflection means it just reflect us. In the same things, in the reflexive pronouns, it reflects to the subject in the sentences, and it always ends with the word self or selves. Here the two words is given here. See the example, S-E-L-F, self, and self means S-E-L-V-E-S. So we can see the example here, the boy kicked himself. Himself goes the direct object. That means himself means the boy's reflection it is there. The himself is reflect to the same sentences to the boy. Now next, here also the word ends with the self, that is S-E-L-F. And herself, in the himself if we are talking, the next comes an indirect object, that means a herself. Now the next example is the she made herself coffee. She, it goes to the reflection of the herself, goes to the reflection to the she. You should address the letter to yourself. Here also the word yourself comes, which reflects to the sentences word you. So these are the examples of the reflexive nouns. Here we can see the example of the reflexive pronouns in the singular form and in the plural form. First things, that is the subject pronouns we will take. I means if reflection, if we will talk in the sentences about the I, that means myself. You, yourself. He, himself. She, herself. It, itself. So these are the words you have to remember in the sentences. And if we will talk about in the plural form, that goes in the singular form and this comes in the plural form. That means the we. The V word is the reflexive pronouns, but it is in the plural form, which comes in the reflection, that goes the ourself. You means yourselves. They means themselves. So these are the things of the examples of the reflexive pronouns. Now the next topic, the last topic is about the demonstratives. It is the words that are used to point out the noun, that is person or the thing to which they are referred. The demonstration word in English are these, that, these and those. See the four words is given here highlighted, which you can see the pronunciation with the spelling also. This, that, these and the those. And the demonstrative adjectives means it modifies a noun. Always this adjective, this demonstrative adjective modifies a noun. So we can see the example here. This apple is good. I like those houses. That means Here the two words is there which modifies as the noun. If we will talk about the sentences in the noun, the apple is the noun and it modifies as the word with the this, that is THIS. And next year also the next noun is the houses which modifies us with the word those. So these two, these and the those are the demonstratives. So now here we will see the example of the demonstrative pronouns and the adjective. Both the things is the pronouns and the adjectives. The words which is the words also we can say, or we can say the things which is nearby us, that is in the singular form, when the things is near, we will use the word this. And in the same in the singular form, when the things is far away from us, at that time we will use the word that. And in the same demonstrative, we will see in the second form, that is the plural form. Then the things are in the near, the word just go to the these, that is THESE. And when the things are far away from us in the plural form, that the words are used as a THOSE. You can see the example which with the picturization here. This is an apple which is in the singular form and it is nearby us. That is an apple, that means this is also in the singular form but it is far away from us. And the third one is the these are apples. So many apples are there. That is in the plural form. And the words are used as a these because it is in the nearby us. Those are apples which is far away from us and it is also in the more than one apple. That is in the plural form. The words are used as a those. So I hope so all the points are clear. Thank you.